Hi everybody, and welcome to a special session that we have today. Today we are here to welcome Ms. Amy Daly Gardner. She is the Associate Dean and Director of Graduate Student Recruitment at Clark University in Massachusetts. So welcome Amy to IDP. It's a pleasure to have you with us.
Thank you very much. Okay.
So Amy, would you like to tell our audience a little bit about yourself and what is it that you do at Clark University?
Sure, thanks so much for having me. Again, my name is Amy Daly Gardner and I'm the Associate Dean and Director of Graduate Recruitment at Clark. I've actually been at Clark for over 21 years, not all in this position. I started out in 2000 as the Director of the International Students and Scholars Office, so I've had a long experience working with international students at Clark. And then most recently was the Associate Dean for International Programs. I was very excited when they asked me to move over to graduate recruitment about 6 months ago. And so I'm excited to be working at this part of Clark.
Well, thank you, Amy. So Amy, we have a lot of questions for you that a lot of students usually ask us. So we thought, why not speak with you directly and you can kind of give some information and advice to our students who might be interested. So our first question is, why do you think students should choose the US as a study abroad destination, generally speaking?
Great, thanks. That's a terrific question. Well, I think the first is that students, Clark University, the United States, has a wide variety of different types of universities. So students in India and in other countries have a very broad choice. Another thing that I think is really important to understand is that the educational system is different in the US.
Right.
And so while the US is student-centered, and what I mean by that is the whole educational system is centered around the student learning. Mm-hmm. And so, whereas in another country, another educational system, you have a faculty member or professor standing at the head of a very large auditorium lecturing for quite a long time, students taking notes, and then perhaps one big exam or two big exams per semester or per year will then give all of this information back. There's really not a lot of thought and critical thinking. The US is quite the opposite, actually. Students are expected to engage in the subject matter, to ask questions, to challenge professors, which is unheard of in other cultures.
Right.
And so I think that it really is a way for students to discover their academic prowess and really learn at a different level.
Absolutely, Amy. Yep. Having been an international student myself, I definitely can agree with the style of teaching. It's something that students from, say, South Asian region generally may not be used to, but I think once they get used to it, they find it rather refreshing. That's my hope, at least.
Yes.
Now, Amy, every student is aware that the US is generally known for STEM, so science, technology, engineering, mathematics. So could you please elaborate, like, what are other fields that students could explore also in the US aside from the more popular ones that come under STEM?
Sure, of course. I think one area, the United States has so many different majors that some majors and some degree programs that probably students have never heard of before. Mm-hmm. And so I think it's important for them to open their minds a little bit when they're looking at the US for education. I'll give you one example, liberal arts education. Very often people think that that is sculpture, music, art, painting. It's really not. What a liberal arts education does is it prepares you to be a critical thinker and to solve problems. And if you talk to employers, those are two skills that they're most interested in having in their new employees. And so, at least at the undergraduate level, a liberal arts education can be a very broad-based academic program. Again, many students outside of the US have never even heard of that or a little bit of a shy away from
it.
Yes.
Right. Well, thank you for shedding some light on that. Now, you know, students always, or typically parents will ask, okay, I've done my degree, then what? Mm-hmm. Right? So what are the opportunities a student could look at post their education or post degree completion in the US?
Of course, of course. Well, I'll start with the immigration side of things because that is so critical, obviously.
Yes.
So any student that comes to the United States in an F1 student visa status is eligible for work authorization in their field of study, which is called optional practical training, affectionately known as OPT. And so students get at least 12 months, and if they are in a STEM designated program, they get up to 36 months. And that allows them to work in their field of study, whether that be an internship or a job, and they can get experience working in the US within a U.S. company, whether they just decide to stay in the U.S. And get sponsored for an H-1, or whether they want to come back to their home country.
Okay, all right, thank you. And could you tell us more about Clark University? So, for example, where is it exactly located, and why should a student specifically choose to study at Clark University?
So Clark is a small university. It's about an hour outside of Boston on the east coast of the United States. Worcester, Massachusetts is the city that we're located in. It's the second largest city in Massachusetts. And so it's not Boston with very high skyscrapers, but it has its own allure and its own charm. Worcester is a city of immigrants. And so there are all different people that live in the Worcester County area. Plus it's home to 10 other universities and colleges. And so it's a learning city.
Mm-hmm.
Clark is, like I said, small, and why we think that's important is because students get attention. They get attention from their professors, and they get attention from the staff and faculty. We really do want our students to have a positive academic and social experience. And so I think that that's probably why I would really encourage students to look at Clark. Of course, academics are the most important, right?
Yeah.
And so Clark is has very strong academic programs. We're ranked very highly in U.S. News and World Report. We also have an AACSB accredited business school, which only 5% of the business schools worldwide have that accreditation, and we're very proud of that. We also have other programs that are internationally ranked as well. And so I think that you pair up an excellent educational experience and a very positive, welcoming community. And I think that's why Clark is a special place for international students.
Okay, sounds wonderful. And I think the fact that you yourself have worked there so long is a testament to the fact that people probably really love it there too. So Amy, specifically at Clark University, which are the top programs where you see students have been applying? Generally, or whether it's specifically, say, from the South Asia region? And are there any programs that you think they might be interested in, but they may not know enough about yet?
That's a really good question. So obviously the STEM programs. We have programs in data analytics, business analytics, and computer science, and information technology and project management. Those are probably the top majors right now, the most popular.
Okay.
I think what's interesting is I think often students think about these majors, these programs as being a sure thing in terms of getting jobs. There are other programs actually that are really quite promising. So okay, maybe not as trendy right now, but I'll give you one example is accounting. And so the top four accounting firms will hire, they're constantly hiring graduates of a Master's of Science in Accounting program. And they get good salaries, really good salaries. And so I think that, and there aren't as many people studying accounting. And so the competition for the jobs after graduation is a little bit less.
Right.
And so I think it may not be as trendy. And you can always have, for example, at Clark, we have the Master's of Science in Accounting, but we also have a Master's of Science in Accounting Analytics, which gets that STEM designation.
Mm-hmm.
So that would give them a longer period of work authorization after.
Right.
So that's just one example.
Okay, no, that's a very interesting point because I think many students may not be aware of such programs, so it's always good for them to kind of expand their horizons of what they're looking at. Now, Amy, you spoke to this a little bit, but specifically, what are employment opportunities post their education in Clark? So how many students do you see going through for OPT or even maybe while they're studying in terms of internships or co-ops?
Right.
Could you shed some light on that?
Sure. Each of our schools actually has a career services office that works with students from the time that they come to campus.
Okay.
So it's not a last semester type of relationship. They start right away doing resume building workshops, skill building workshops, building their portfolio so that when it is time for them to get an internship or to get a job after they graduate, that they have something to, they're marketable. And each career services office will tailor make the programming for their graduates. So for example, in our international development community and the environment, they have job fairs with employers like Esri, like Idrisi, and they bring them to campus so that students actually get connected to these specific employers. So yes, I would say the majority of international students do apply, especially from India, do apply for OPT, and it is granted. It's not something that they can turn down.
Sure.
Our students have been really, really fortunate, and we've been fortunate to be able to help them find positions. So we help them find internships, and mm-hmm. then also then we help them find their first landing space, you know, once post-graduation.
Okay, great, great. So I hope all the students tuning in today are listening to that information. Now, related to this, Amy, we get a lot of questions regarding scholarships. So what kind of scholarship opportunities are available for international students at Clark?
Sure. And I want to speak directly to the students,
yes,
because
please.
That's most important. Clark values international students, and so we put our money where our mouth is, and we do offer generous scholarships. And it really, they're merit scholarships. So we look at an application and the transcripts, the grades that the student got in their undergraduate experience. Also any work experience, all of that factors into a merit scholarship. And the amount of scholarship depends on the program. So some programs we have up to 50% scholarship, other programs up to 30%. And usually those programs have a lower price point. So you're still, you know, it's in line with the price point of the program. But we look at your application and we give you the scholarship at the time that you're admitted. We don't have play games. We don't want to, we want to give you the scholarship that you deserve so that you know how to make it work to come to Clark. So that you're not guessing, that you're not stressed out. That's very important to us, actually.
Okay, no, that's wonderful. Now, Amy, what are some of the positive changes you have seen since the Biden administration came into power? Have you seen any impact on international education generally, the sentiment of international students, and maybe how that relates to Clark University?
Sure, thank you. Yes, I think that in general, this new administration is friendlier to international students and international cooperations across the board. And so we see applications for optional practical training not taking as long as we saw before, and just different opportunities that we did not see before, or that were stymied under the old administration. We are excited that the State Department is very active with recruiting again internationally post COVID, and so we're excited about the future now for international education.
Okay, that sounds good and very promising. So I hope that's reassuring to many of you out there who still might be considering whether US is the right option for you or not. So in closing, Amy, I wanted to ask you, is there any pieces of advice or a major piece of advice you would like to give to students who are considering the US, and then specifically if they might be looking at Clark University also?
Sure, I guess one piece of advice I would say is keep an open mind and do your research. There are so many options within the United States, and it's really worth your while to spend some time, do your research, and reflect on what you really want to do with your career. And so I guess that would be the biggest piece generally. Specifically about Clark, we really want to engage with you in Clark grad admissions. And so please reach out to us. Please come visit us if you can, either that be virtually or in person. We are here, we have graduate assistants that are available to help you pretty much every hour of the day.
Mm-hmm.
And so take advantage of that. We feel that you're our customer, and we are excited to have you at Clark, and we want to be the ones to welcome you. So take advantage of that.
Thank you, Amy, for the wonderful advice. And thank you for spending some time with us today and sharing your insights with the students and parents who might be listening. And to all of our students and parents, thank you for tuning in today. We at IDP provide end-to-end services for international education services, so everything from your profile assessment to application submission, helping you prep for visa interviews, you know, your pre-departures. We will guide you. We have a team of education experts across the country and the region who will help you with everything, including applying to Clark University if that's something that fits what you are looking for. And you know, you can please get connected to us through our website. Please subscribe and follow us on our various social media channels, and there you will find many more interesting videos such as this posted for your reference. So thank you again, and I'm signing off for IDP.